Hello, Tubers. Hope you're doing well. We have the Genshin Live stream for 510 in roughly 4 minutes starting. And you should definitely watch the shit. Also, what the fuck is this go? There we go. Apparently, there's a jumping dragon on screen. That's already peak, okay? Let's be real. It's pixel art, it's what's the shit called? You know exactly what I mean. The game where we jump, Flappy Bird. Yeah, Flappy Bird, that's one. Thanks, son. Appreciate it. Ads should be playing in like a few seconds, I think. Let me check quickly here. Wait. There we go. I will press the S button just right now. This way, they won't be playing definitely before the shit starts. Also, I like the black screen here because the chat is just not loading on YouTube because it's fucking YouTube. If the volume's too low, tell me. If the volume is too high, tell me. I'll up it a little bit. So let's see. Ooh, can't wait. That's gonna be nice. The question is, will the Flappy Dragon die when the thing starts or not? Like, asking the very important questions right now. There you go. 16 lives, what do you mean 16 lives? Is he inting now 16 times in a row? Is he on tilt controls? Doesn't seem like it. Let's see what they're showing us, okay? I kinda hope they show us some food as well in the region. Because this way I can prepare for my 24 hour stream. Fun fact. I'll do a fun 24-hour stream on release date of Natlan, which is the 28th of this month, which is August. It's August, right? Do we have August? I think we have August. So yeah, I hope you'll be there. Shit's gonna be amazing. How long till stream? I can't see here. Bro, can you even do anything in your life, man? Dawn, what the fuck is going on? Like 0 minutes. Anyways, to answer those questions, it should be starting now. I don't know why it didn't start yet. But yeah. Also, Tubers. In the description, I'll put the links. Not the links, the codes for the stream. Okay? This way you can easily just use them. Where they are late. Ah, there we go. St- stage clear. That was a stage, are you dumb? What?
We've arrived at the final phase. The winner of this match will take the final spot among the victors. Give it up for a long time contender. And first time finalist.
First time finalist?
From this point forward, everything we know about the world no longer applies. Anything can happen here. There's something in the depths of this place that feels familiar, yet also foreign.
The Pokemon tournament arc. Oh my god, we finally see Ash Ketchum live in action.
Also a stage upon which to showcase your individual growth.
They show him first. Is he the first one? No. Kachina. I hope I get more Lani, man. I don't want to lose a 50-50 again. I lost too many. She's fucking adorable. Wait, he jumps sideways? Okay.
Guess I'll have to wait until the next pilgrimage. I'm still not sure why Arwayup chose me of all people.
It took the combined efforts of the then Pyro Archon and heroes from every tribe to finally repel the Abyss.
Oh my god, so, it's dinosaurs! Oh my god, it's dinosaurs! Poor me. Poor Rami. They're Diaz. Oh my god, there's Shikunoko. Oh my god, Capoeira.
Really
no fucking way.
And become a true warrior.
But through our long history of fighting the Abyss, we've realized things aren't quite so
fighting
simple.
The Abyss?
The Abyss has invaded the Night Kingdom and has the capacity to read the memories of this land at any given moment.
Going there. The Night Kingdom?
Only those who triumph over the Abyss earn the right to be revived. Defeat not only means death, but also the destruction of your ancient name, preventing it from ever being inherited again.
You heard something from here, didn't you?
Kinich, what is the meaning of this?
Only one way to awaken you all from your willful blindness.
I think it was Kapitan's
voice. Must be made.
You'll die if you try to make your way forward. Why don't you just give up?
You want to know why I won't give up?
I should have died 5 years ago. Take me as your next sacrifice.
Natlan is on the verge of destruction.
Oh my
it's
god, she's stacked.
Our nation has less than a year before total devastation.
The Mill of Archon.
Once your ancient name disappears, there's no coming back.
Wait, ancient name disappearing? Oh my god, it's Shaska or whatever the fuck her name is.
Every great display of power comes at a price.
The tragedy of your short life.
Yansan? Ooh.
You understand nothing of all encompassing power.
You shall unite the tribes and save Natlan from its impending doom.
Okay, announcer voice, who's dead? It must be Capitano, right?
What use is the new
everything in the nation about hands to be destroyed? I don't know.
I don't know what you mean.
Oh, but Claymore! Like wait, yeah, war. Man. Claymore Archon.
Your plan has reached
Capitano?
And now it falls to me to create new rules for Natlan.
Wait, people he's like Cryo. Us. That's Cryo. That's
wait,
definitely Cryo. Burning hair? Oh shit! Nah! Oh fucking shit! Ooh! Okay. Mmm! Thanks, Soyo. That way.
这次远程前瞻啊，有些特殊任务需要我亲自完成。我去找项目同学问一下。Maybe
I should enable CC. I guess that's a pretty good idea. German, I probably think that's a bad idea. Dude, oh. Feedback from travelers. Oh my god. Focus on summarizing. I wonder if he saw me spend like... Okay, I don't know. I don't know if he saw me spam more fish events. Probably he did.
挺好的。准备领原石。
Ready to claim Primo Gems. Let's go.
各位女士们，大家好，欢迎来到原神5.0前瞻特别节目。我是你们老朋友大伟哥。 那么今天呢，我们又请到了我们的项目组老朋友啊，战斗设计师鸡哥，我们的 IP 负责人小罗浩。Hello，
大家好，我是大家的老朋友鸡哥。那这一次来到 Aclaria
is a very weird name for
Chinese
players, not gonna lie.
新的版本，也就是纳塔这片区域上的游戏内容的一些设计思路和设计理念。
大家好，我是你们的老朋友小罗浩。那个很荣幸还是。 由我来在这个一年一度的这个大版本啊，就是和大家分享一些我们纳塔的世界观和角色相关的一些信息和情报。
Dude, that opening trailer already so hype. Holy shit, man! Dude, the burning hair. That's like,
peak.
When we get her, she has that too. Also, she uses claymore, which is perfect. So basically, it's Himiko.
那大家别紧张啊！之前我们不是做过一轮那个问卷调查吗？大家其实对我们那个纳塔其实都是非常非常感兴趣的。那么今天啊，我们也是专门把这些问题挑出来。
Selected some questions. Where are the fish ravens? Maybe they answer them.
就没有稿子吗？不要紧张，不要紧张，对吧？肯定是大家都很熟悉的问题啊。那么要不先试试看？
It seems like she will be on field because of the hair, but hopefully not.
那我看一下。
I mean, I kind of wanted to be on feed because that's what the Archons are missing.
让我们来看VCR。在4.0版本的前瞻直播当中呢，项目组有提到过，
oh my god, a fucking in real life YouTuber.
那这次就是新的大世界移动体系，那是在Pyro DPS。Imagine。More on Pyro DPS。有解决什么技术上的难题吗？对的，会比Hilary是吧？Adam Jungling and Factoma。这部分也是我的专业领域嘛。And Dale。Dale是Defeat2。I guess。原神其实是一个开放世界游戏，当然这个大家都知道，对吧？但在我们的理解里面，其实开放设计游戏它。The
pure damage element.
更关注的两个是。
What are your predictions about Pyro Archon's kit? Attack steroid, probably. That works for the entire team. Like 40-50% of some shit. I wouldn't surprise you, please. Like it must be a huge attack steroid that she has.
火元素打一下冰雾花，这冰雾花可能就变成一个可以采集的状态，对吧？那Dale
is not a character's ult. That thing exists to exist.
那这次我们想换一个思路，我们想在交互的形式上去做一些花样。
If she's a pure DPS, I won't be happy. I mean, she will probably be a DPS with like team boosting abilities. Like, let's be real, that's what Archons do. Like, look at Raiden, for example. She's on T DPS, burst DPS, that gives everybody energy. So, Nahida can work as a driver, can be on field, obviously. Frina can be on field, obviously. But have like this supportive niche they have. Like Nahida gives EM, Raiden gives ER, Frina gives elemental damage. So she probably gives attack. At least that's what I predict.
It's
gonna be like Benny. And like on 50 best, yeah, probably. Except that hell shit probably will work even for characters off field. Okay, that's what I hope, hopefully. That if she's using her ult, that your entire team gets an attack steroid, and that it works, listen, that's important. And that it works, even if she's switching out, that her ult is not gonna get cancelled. Because that way, she would be peak with fishes. But there's nothing for Marina, I guess, yeah.
其实是算技能，但是我觉得呢，就像刚才
But that's just Hydro as an element. The Hydro is like very locked into HP. I'm assuming it's buffing attack team, yeah. But the, I want her to use her ult, get the flamey flamey hair here, and then I can switch her out if I want to. Use Fischl's E, so Fischl can snapshot the attack boosted attack, attack damage garbage. And then go to the rest of the team, do their shit, put her on the field, and slap the shit out of enemies. That's what I hope, okay? feels like
this is Meru level region for me at the moment.
Damn,
that's good issues.
I can't assume it follows too,
because probably it has
it. Yeah, it's gonna be a global thing, I assume. Like, they did that with Furina already. Furina's ult works on entirety of Tibet. It's not a fucking circle or like an area around you. It just works straight up everywhere.
Genus
Invocation, yeah, I don't care. Exploration mechanics with Sorin. Flying Sorin at the end. We can fly. Spoil it. Oh my god. All different types of Saurians that players will see not long will have unique exploration mechanic. Oh my god, nice. I forgot to look at what they're saying. Don't worry, I will say the important things if I see something. I'm too high for the shit, man. Anyways, all the Saurians we saw in the previous trailer, they will be our exploration tool. Where you are from? YouTube. Because YouTube, if there's something happening, I can rewind. Ooh, look at this. Nice. Oh my god, he can spit shit and... That's not. Oh, I mean Dawn. Oh, your phone. Oh my god, man. The surfing seems very fast as well. We'll be able to fly. Yes, please. I can say, please forward to the content. Go fuck it. Probably not 4.0 by 4.1 then. Like they did in Fontaine, where we got the bomb underwater thing, the mine, on second page instead of the first page. He saw he saw a mountain peak or something, it could be two. Maybe he had too much cocaine as well, that he will be not pulling, as always. Oh, I said that shit, man. Sorry, that's my plan. Look at the clean little shit. Oh my god, my starter Pokemon. I need that. I want that my teapot. Oh my god, they live with the Saurian together. This is so neat. Pet Impact, it's actually Pokemon Impact.
Oh my god.
Dude. Don't shit talk Miraidon and Coraidon, okay? Both of them are insanely based. I'm an actual Miraidon sim. It's like one of the best Pokemon IDs I ever had. Yeah, I know them. Don't worry.
That's all there is, Will.
Basically, Miraidon means something with future, and Coraidon means something with past, which is actually fitting to the story and the thing. Shrubbish man, what rubbish? That's a rubbish. That's a clone show.
那第三题呢，也是个特殊问题。我们来看VCR。这次又是哪位大佬？Westbrook，ever.
So guys, I'm Twanto, and I'm here to ask some questions.
Who the fuck is that piece of shit?
Team regarding 5.0. Pyro's the spotlighted element for the new update, specifically for Natlin. And I'm curious,
Toronto.
How does
okay.
Pyro have a significance in Natlin? Will Natlin be more accessible for newer players in the game? Because I do know that a lot of newer players have difficulties and or struggle
new players
to get
have
to the newer pieces
with everything.
Of content that get
like,
added to the game. Honestly, it is insane
they start to
that
breathe and die from it.
Now, I want to give you guys all my luck because
I want exploration
I
to be harder, man.
I hope at the
that's
very
what
least,
my wishes is.
You can.
For
and I hope you find your own true meaning on your own journey.
And I want
in Genshin Impact.
Tells us, okay?
But
brain dead shit like that in Sumeru or Fontaine. I want actually puzzles. I want to use my brain. We will never have real puzzles in Zuma. Yeah, it's probably not going to be happening. I mean, they had us at 2.8. They had pretty decent puzzles, I would say. But besides that, it's dead. It's straight up dead. They'll be like, okay, never mind. People are complaining too much. All of them are pussies. We hate them. Fuck these players, man.
然后纳塔历代有很多英雄和英杰，他们用自己的精神力量将纳塔的火不断的向未来、向新一代去传递。无论他们遇见了怎样的艰难和挑战
，Fucking loud minority man, they're annoying.
我们一直知道那个纳塔被
You should get rid of them, cancel them all.
那么其中这个战争的含义
What does war mean in this context? Okay, now the important part.
纳塔是战争的国度，是因为纳塔在历史上
has faced countless crises throughout history.
那么为了保护 to protect the homeland, 我们之前提到纳塔的人民还有纳塔的龙，他们一起并力同心抵御着各种侵害纳塔的势力。那么在一场又一场这样的战斗中，涌现出了无数的英雄。
It's a very cool black stone. That's also very cool black stone. That's also very cool black stone. Are those the Statue of the Seven?
Wouldn't surprise me.
At least they're cool stones.
We
need more like that.
那么到了如今呢，六大部族之间依然会彼此竞争，在圣火竞技场所举办的大赛中比拼各项的能力，从而选拔出最强的战士。
By the way,
Tubas,
in case you're wondering,
继续上的战士。Why
that thumbnail? It's 6 a.m. Okay, I'm tired of shit.
这个战争并不是我们。
I expected it to be happening like that, so I'm not surprised.
对吧？其实。
No more chocolate woman. I mean, we have Mulani. That's good enough. Also, look at her. Oh my God, Shasuke. Chocolate woman. Look at Also, you have Yan-san. If you are into that kind, probably not. I hope not.
几乎有这个五成的这个问卷啊，都提到了这个火神啊，相信那个李星怎么样都很好奇。Yeah, Pyrocon's cool, but fishy. 那李星怎么样在纳塔又会火神？火神嘛，我们简单来说，他就是纳塔人的领袖，就纳塔所有战士里面的最强人、最强者。那火神率领着纳塔的士兵迎接了无数的战争，夺得了无数的胜利。Oh my god.
I will get Yan-san, Mulani, Oruboss, possibly. At least we don't know much yet, but the eyes look very feminine, I guess. Whatever,
okay.
Yeah, full of confidence. Also that fucking sexy-ass biker suit. Let's not ignore that part. Oh my gosh, he's logging into Asia. At gmail.com, okay. He's gonna be like Kutao, I hope not, man. And the tech buff, EP team void. I mean, that's definitely the captain. Always wears a helmet. Heatstroke, Natlan, Squash, and Zula.
No.
Probably not. He's a cry character. Like, the sword he summoned looked very.
我可能说的远一些，就是，战争的国度嘛，它必然会伴随着牺牲，那死亡从来都无法被轻易逆转。但是呢，在纳塔，唯独在纳塔，就是我们英雄们的火焰不太会
轻易的熄灭。就我们足迹皮语里面说到，戴英说过一句谜语嘛，就败者成为战火的余烬而胜者重燃。
对，
那在纳塔牺牲是无法阻拦英雄们奋战的脚步的，他们是有机会去继续战斗，直到那一场战争彻底的终结。
Yeah,
at least
it looked like it.
Okay.
But maybe that's his delusion. Okay. It could be that it's his delusion. But considering Alexino had Pyro and Pyro delusion, it doesn't mean anything,
okay?
Also, we already had a delusion for Ice, which is Ziggy. Ziggy had Ice.
Maybe
we get his delusion version as David? I don't think so.
对对，那刚才
David not do that.
不能说太多了。
至于说刚才那个奇妙的问题，说他
unless the delusion is the same as the element he uses, which is a possibility once again.
可能由于某种原因，我觉得他
I think they will spread it out. They will be using animal delusion somewhere. They use cryo delusion somewhere. Power delusion on Alexino. I think they will go this way. Okay.I think that seems more reasonable to me. But it could be that they're not going to do that. It's just something that would be neat. There we have it, in real life trip. And it's Mualani. Except she looks nothing like Mualani. But she has animation. I thought Ziggy Delusion was Pyro. No. She's the burning witch. The burning witch of flames, okay?Dude, I fucking won't tell. Just because of Shark, man. Shark. Okay. This is how you get me, man. Just Shark. Okay. Also, she's cute as fuck, gotta say. Oh my god, that drive-by. Oh, she is, she's ka-ching ka-ching.I'm gonna skip her, call if I get Emmy, thank you. The Dr. Eggman. Dude, I swear to God, she's Dr. Eggman. I don't care, man. Otherwise, I would go for her too. I will probably go for her still because Shark, okay? It's like... Okay, that's Kinich. Yeah, I'm well aware. Thanks for you. I want the hot man, dude. You are way too fucking horny, man.I very much doubt I will skip Archon weapon cause no good place. That is fucking true. You have a point on that part. His enchanted jumps and this grappling hook thingy, which is cool as fuck. The question is just how well can he use it? If he can spam it, then he might be a must pick. Oh shit, there's a promo code. I put it in chat. Also, once again, it's down below.I'm too good. V59DLFD. Yeah, shut up, son, okay? It's not about you, it's about me, okay? I'm the main person here. Anyways, down below. I will use it.Just you know, it works. Redeemed successfully. There you go. Easy. Yes, Dawn. I know you're a little slow, but I'd never expect you to be that slow. He's on 2 minute delay. Dude, he's on next level delay.This guy is in patch 4.1 right now, man. Now let's show please the character. Be nice to me, Shumi-senpai. Yeah, A whole, you win 50-50, there you go. Oh my god. That way rage quit, it's over. 4.1 was good time. Nah man, it was jail. Dude, it was straight up Fontaine jail. Just before Fontaine got good.
I guess. Ooh, we
Act 1 and 2, as always. Pilgrimage of Return, good return. Yeah, we like pilgrimages, I guess.
Okay, okay, 我知道你在说哪一位了。
那就是在之前的节目当中跟我们有见面过的那一位
小姑娘
叫卡奇娜。
The cars guy.
卡奇娜是霍
真卡奇娜的
回声之子的股民持有者。
Not weapon,
his car. 而他的股民乌沙伯蒂。
His name is, I could not read that.
坚强。
虽然他自己并不明白为什么会被赐予这个伟大的名字，因为有很多古代的英杰和先烈，他们都曾经持有这个名字。
Two people, let's go baby.
但是他认为他既然得到了这个殊荣，他就有义务参与这个在圣火竞技场举行的归火圣殿巡礼。虽然他一直屡战屡败，但是他也屡败屡战。所以
I just saw Dark Moon, oh my god. Dude, don't tell that Twitter, they will cancel you.
那我觉得应该也是一个很
好的。Remy Lenin,
他的这个载具，我们把它叫做。
All I care about is this shit, man. Like, that's peak Genshin. That's
像钻头一样的。
The Eggman thing.
他在比赛中，提供一定的助力吧。
No
one's coming. 首先，卡奇娜就像大家看到的那样，他其实是一位岩元素神之眼的持有者。那么，他也会通过自己的技能来召唤出刚才我们一直有聊到的那个
冲天转转。
冲天转转就是这样一个像钻头一样的载具。那么，它有不同的方
式跟冲天
转转之间
进行交互。It's what Eggman is using, okay?
比如说，它可以
But it's also one of these segways.
然后通过这种方式来提供
快速移动啊，探爬墙面啊，以及可以在这种情况下去冲击地面来攻击
敌人。以及可以在这种情况下去冲击地面来攻击敌人。那它同样也可以把冲天转转当做一个单独的战斗单位进行召唤，那么它也会独立的产生元元素伤害，而它的元素
伤害会划定
一个施工场地一样的领域。那在这个领域里面呢，其实冲天转转也会获得一些强化的。
Wait, she can remount it. That's pretty cool.
除了这些战斗的技巧以外，那卡奇娜当然她作为部族的勇士，
有一些当地人的作用。I'm gonna predict it before they say it, but you will be free. Yeah, probably.
那么熟悉大塔的当地区域，也就是说。
She's our entry character, and she's probably available after 5.0 as well, where we get her in Abyss for free, and then it's 7, 8, I don't know. Chiori team, yep. That's the plan. Word exclamation. Shortly after the Natlan Arc Conquest, there we go. Okay, there you go, son. Good prediction. Fantastic, man.
Nice.
There you go, Mulani. Nice, I can't wait. She's a fucking cutie, I gotta say. Nobody could have guessed that one. Yeah, no. They're like, dude.
那作为流泉之众的成员呢？马拉尼他酷爱
各类
运动。
Dude, look at this man.
比如说游泳、跳水、冲浪，还有沙滩排球。
Nah, man, she's a vibe.
但是自己玩的开心，他更享受和大家。
She's the first not blonde girl.
无论是他作为水上用品商店的店主，还是作为一个新生代的向导中的佼佼者呀。
Okay, never mind,
Julie.马拉尼他都非常乐意和他人推荐一个充满乐趣和惊喜的旅程。那么在不足迹闻流泉之众当中呢，旅行者就有机会和马拉尼一起探寻传说中啊神秘岛屿的一个旅程。那相信已经称霸五国的旅行者一定不会错过这样的冒险和挑战。
因为他也是流泉之众的勇士。那么他在战斗中
，Yeah, I would not simple them. I'm sorry.
首先，大家
，Charlotte, I would not simple her too.You don't understand the word simping, I guess, okay?
You
can be attractive, but I'm not simping for you. That, it's simple. Wait. Wait.
This is...
Ooh. Nah, man. Dude, I can't... Oh my god, I can't surf. Oh, man.
Oh
my god. Do we kickflip? Do we kickflip? Nah, man. Dude, this is fucking hilarious.
主动发起的攻击当中，这些行为会给他提供非常大的注意
啊，就积累资源，
Damn Vlad was with her. There's no way I will ever send for her, man. You see TDU Genshin Impact simply. No, man. I see TD and be like, nice, I like TD. Shark bit is better than I expected. Dude, it looks fucking amazing. Also, if you're on water, the stamina doesn't go away, as it seems like. Also can surf on fucking planet Earth, man. Dude, nah, this is fucking amazing. This is the Genshin. That is really pretty. I disagree. I think she's fine, but that's about it.
哇，那不愧是我们流泉之中最好的向导呀！它的移动方式又很特别，然后又很
灵活。You need personality for me to simp, okay?
去探索大世界。
The right personality, like a good personality.
就是说，它在纳塔这些存在燃素，刚才我们有提到。
And so far, she doesn't have that. So
I would not say.
Nice, nice. She has my passive. She has the overworld passive.
最后一位。
So like Furina, yeah, no. I want my girl to not be a murderer, okay? That killed half of Poisson. That's also a requirement, okay? I said don't know to think about
Kinich.
So far I think he could be extremely good for exploration, not gonna lie. But of Wanderer, okay. But he seems to be faster than Wanderer, and this is concerning. If Wanderer gets power crap like that, I want to refund him.
5 seconds
are good for explore, yeah. Doesn't Wanderer from Natlan at least? Yes, that's true.
There's
a guy 5-star. Yeah, he's a 5-star. The Shark Girl is a 5-star and he's a 5-star. Also, it's Sasuke. And Naruto. Naruto is the Little Dragon. The Japanese VA at least.
Okay.
I don't know if I want him to be honest, because yeah. You said you will not put for anybody, so you have to stick with that, otherwise you are coping. Shark guy is faster, yes. The shark waifu is a
faster.
I did say man, no.
Yeah, I guess.
But he's not a man, he's a guy, okay? He's a kid. He's a teen model, so get fuck it. Keep in mind, he doesn't have the height of consent. I really like the 8-bit animation things. Dude, he's fast as fuck, man. What? Also, the sideways jumping, that's fucking cool, I gotta say. Like, this is actually fucking amazing. I really like that. He seems to be like what Kazuha should be. Yes, Buddha Man, yes. It feels weird to me that he's so fast. Dude, he feels extremely fast, man. He's Buddha Man, yeah, he's Buddha Man. Dude, that's his ult.
那和其他两位也是一样，你大概会猜到基尼奇。
But he seems very fast. And if he doesn't have much cooldown, then yeah, Wanderer, it's not worth to put anymore. People, if you see that, don't put Wanderer. Okay, it's not worth it anymore. Put him. Wait, what? He can see specialties too? Wait, what? Or did I miss something? Movement speed of all party members.
Okay.
Wait, what? Wait, what? Wait, do they have two passes? Did I miss something? She's damaged, etc. before the side. I don't give a fuck with him.
He's
also gonna be burnty.
Is he?
Also, they are nice shiny. Night Soul Blessing. Fully showcase their power.
这能力我就接过话茬，是通过我们这位称为一种叫做燃素刻录的仪式来激发的。
Something something graving.
这是一种古老的仪式啊，在纳塔地区神之眼的持有者。 不仅可以与部族的大灵和地脉进行沟通，还能通过这个仪式强化自己的实力。
OK， 这个大灵听起来好像
Oh my God, it's God. No, it's the angel. It's
图腾和信仰。
原来如此。那也就是说，有了夜魂加持这种
全新 thing，
概念的加入会导致纳塔会有一些完全不一样。
It's not London Pinot, but usually it's pretty much.
作为设计者呢，其实也对这些体验做了一些便利性的设计。那我们从 5.0 开始，重新制作了一部分且试身手的活动场地。
Environment of test run.
且试身手的场地会
Oh wait, what?
完全是纳塔风格的，类似大世界这样的。
世界观察，
旅行者们就可以在这样的一个区域里面很方便的。
Okay, that's cool. Also, I got the
chibi. 进行更深度的游玩和体验。我知道肯定介绍完这三个人。
That's very fucking nice. Okay. Overworld.
在每个国家，只要
test run，
触碰一下，
This is cool.
获得这个国家的相关元素的对这个能力。那么在纳塔，他是不是也能够很顺利的去接触到火元素的能力，并且也和这些角色一样，有夜魂加持的效果呢？
That's actually pretty neat.
这个就要提前和大家说明一下了。那么这次旅行者来到纳塔和
天使上，First was met with a statue. There we go. Pyro
Trend. 由于某种不知名的原因，旅行者并不能立刻。
Cannot immediately wake power.
那关于这个奇怪的现象，其实涉及到
Oh my God, we lost our power.
面临到的一些种种的危机。
How long will
leave us now? 那等旅行者们在纳塔的旅程进一步深入的时候，就能够得到详细的解答了。
我相信啊，
为如何？
刚才介绍得到这些
，Not Pyro Traveler in 5.0。
Oh my God！ 角色，因为之前我
们有过，
以凡聊著名的这样的一个视频。
对，
比如说啊，我们还有更早期的一个卫星角色，就是
足迹当中的
对对对，
岩山
足迹 PV 里已经露面的伊安山，包括像我有印象的还有
Chaska， yeah， the fucking move，
火神这样的角色。
She's not a move probably， but
剧情当中是否都会在 5.0 的版本中
？When is Alice？
哎，七哥就观察的很仔细啊。
5.2 Pyro Traveler, yeah, imagine we are the Pyro Archon. I fucking love her design, man. Also, Thigh Strap, it's Neurons Activation.
Yes, I'm here!
I
can't wait,
no.
Stubborn, yeah, quite literally. Probably lost mother as well, died or some shit, and now she's wearing her fucking skull as a head thing.
我们的队长和火神这两位强者对强者之间，他们会擦出怎样的火花吧？
Oh my god.
而在其他 PV 中出现的角色，就比如说来自我们回声之子。
Yeah, I don't care about her.Like she's the only character I don't give a fuck about, and she, I somewhat don't give a fuck too.
版本中陆续与各位旅行者们见面。
The Just Said Capitano is the strongest of the two.
角色之后呢，就接下来拜托。
Yeah, yes, the number one. Yes, he's number one of the two. I could have told you that ages ago.
那好，那就这次还是由我来给大家。
He's not the refrigerator, which is number zero probably, which is the head of the Fatui or some shit. Okay, Mulani and Kazu trash. Good. And Kaching Kaching.
Pretty.
Rain Shogun rerun. Okay, there we go. The first Archon. That means the next patch we have again one Archon.
山王长牙和五星法器冲浪时光也将出现在武器活动起源中。
Oh, it's a catalyst.
纳塔地区也新
增了无法可
锻造武器。
Oh, new forgeable.
Ooh.
Wait, I screenshot that part. Put it in the
score. 前瞻的一系列的活动当中，我们会推出一个名为出发火之国的 H5 网页活动。那参与这个网页活动呢，旅行者不但能够直观的了解到即将上线的 5.0 版本的新内容，还能在版本更新后直接通过这个 H5 的玩法
获得三种纳塔地区的钻造武器。
那所有关于这些活动的具体内容呢，也请关注官方后续的公告，了解更多的活动详情。那除了刚才说的全新的武器以外呢，5.0 版本更新以后啊，
New artifacts. Okay, please. What they do?
进城勇者绘卷和黑曜秘典。那这两个名字
，they look good.
就很像是纳塔本土的。
I like the bottom set a lot more. It looks more ancient.
在纳塔挑战全新的铸圣秘境，来获取这两套圣遗物。 那我一口气讲了这么多，应该没有漏掉什么吧。
This big deciding factor, that is true.
我们的新角色。
So we get the for free I want. Only three apparently, and not all five. Maybe I'm wrong.
告一段落了。
嗯，没错。
Maybe I just didn't see it.
那么我也圆满完成了今天的任务。
啊，
那我也要。
I'm done for today, Stephen.
啊，
Oh my god, he's rage quitting as well. I can't believe it.
你可以自己想办法呀。
啊，我自己想办法。
Figure it out yourself.
那我就先不说了，我待会去邀请一下我的小伙伴们，然后。
Yeah, classical. Just put in the fire. Have fun.
行，那请大家拭目以待。
This must be your first time in Natland. Chief says Natland's a little different from other nations.
We have no information about what the artifacts mean. I don't like that.
Because we live in separate tribes rather than having one main city.
That seems extremely laggy. That's not on you. That's how the animation is.
All six tribes gather at the stadium to
compete
and find the strongest warriors. See those people with the Tepetlosaurs? They're from my tribe. I come from the Children of Echoes.
Echoes. Okay, that's...
For our mining skills. The Tepetlosaurs are our friends.
Yeah.
They help us find the prettiest ores.
It kind of gives me Knuckles vibes, not gonna lie.
And that means my tribe has all the best jewelers. When we find a really special gemstone, we use it to decorate our weapons or jewelry. Oh, also, if you have time, you should come watch one of our
Maybe it's an element base or some.
Super fun.
Anyway,
the other contestants
that's possibility.
The people of the springs. That's right. We live alongside
the water.
The Kaholosaurus. Our tribe is a really awesome vacation spot.
Dude, it's fucking Hawaii, man. Nice.
Sorry, got lost in the music for a sec.
Dude, this is so Hawaii, I like it. Dude, look at them, the fucking surfer boy. Oh no. Nah, man, this is peak. Burn Hydro, it's one drop, no. They're not gonna be.
That's why we're such good pals. But make sure you give him some space when it gets busy. And if a grumpy Kaholosaur bites you, do not bite them back.
Do not bite them back, okay?
A lot of places in Natland are covered in lava.
See, lava.
If you plan to go exploring,
but it looks like paint.
I recommend picking a guide from my tribe. For deliveries, look no further than the Scions of the Canopy.
I mean, there will be no fire tribe. Let's just say it like that, okay? Let's be real. There's
Everything
no fire tribe.
Letters to packages. Being quick on our feet is one of our strengths. There's also our hunters who take
because
on a wide range of commissions.
At least that's what I predict, but
look,
we'll see.
Those idiots have a bigger death wish than you.
Extreme sports are popular in my tribe.
The dendro chicken.
Don't worry, the Yunkasaurs will protect them.
He looks so tasty, I gotta say.
Young people from my tribe come here because they like a challenge. Next up.
No cryo makes more sense.
Look, the competition's starting.
Could be.
Next time.
But I don't know. Cryo needs something, okay? Cryo is so in a terrible fucking spot. Cryo needs something, and Hoyo knows that. I'm pretty sure. Taking yes, but didn't we? Okay, fuck. Haha, I'm first. Get fucked, I win. Get fucked, Bozo. And the second code. I'll use the second code too. The link for the website, by the way, is also down in the description. Okay? Just press the more button and you'll see. Oh my god, Def Onzies? Not really, but
close to it. Nah, man. This is cool. Hey,
not gonna lie, I would like to have one of them.
节目都开始了。
The water one I would take easily.
机会难得，你们给大家介绍一下你们自己。
The blue one.
大家好，我是。
I would wear that shit on stream all day long.
我是原神的战斗设计师老杨。平时的主要工作
They probably sell it for like 40 bucks.
然后今天呢，很高兴能到现场给大家亲自做一次龙。
哎，大家好，我是原神的关卡设计师小八。
很荣幸呢，这次能够和大家介绍一下
新一年 level design concept
的场景和关卡设计理念。
欢迎两位。
And away,
那今天我们请到小巴还有老杨来到现场呢，其实是我们接着刚才的话题继续聊。我们已经知道了呀，就是纳塔是一个人和龙共生的国度。那刚才其实我们在之前的介绍里也有谈到说，哎，纳塔的地貌环境啊，其实也跟其他的国家非常的不一样。
哎，是的，我其实也在网上看到了很多这样的评论。
Okay.
对于我们开发者来讲呢，纳塔也是一个非常具有特色的国度，潮酷和多彩是它的关键词。
Colorful,
比方说，旅行者可以在巨大的
山体上面看到多彩的涂鸦。
或者是说在各个部落里面看到
很多
超酷的
要素。那这次我
注意上一件事，
就是老杨，你喜欢你爆的，这是什么？I wanted to see everything burn, lava everywhere. I want to live on the volcano.
I don't
know what these people are thinking.
在纳塔我们已经知道它是一个人和龙结合的。
But I hope there's an hazard area. Because that's somewhat important in my opinion. Having a hazard area somewhere,I would say very much needed to spice up exploration.
进行一些复杂的探索的行为。
那接下来我就替老杨来介绍一下。
I mean, to them, the war's entertainment probably, yeah. The war is the Olympics.
旅行者们在纳塔探险的时候呢，就会遇到这一只特别的小
蜜蜂。Oh my god!
我们暂时称它为小家伙吧。小家伙呢，它会陪伴我们，经历很多有趣的小故事，并且也会参与到重要的世界任务当中。
My starter Pokemon.
除了这个小疾风龙这个家伙以外啊，那我知道就是
Not that looks very different from the rest of Genshin. Not really.
那其实今天也很难得，我们有三个小龙人在场，对吧？不如这次我们就眼见为实，带着玩家去逛一圈。
好呀，
可以啊，来来来，我们先去我们疾风龙的部落去看一下我的老
家。So they to move it first. That is true.
这里啊，就是我们回声之子的部落。
哦。
大家可以看到啊，我们这个地方有很多的宝石，也有很多的矿石。同时呢，我们整个建筑的风格也看起来就跟岩元素很有关系。
那已经是他们了，已经
带入了。
是的，我们回声之子啊，一直觉得最强的战士，比如说像我这样的，才能够获得最好的宝石。所以呢，我们去深耕了一下挖掘相关的一些技术。
我来为老杨补充一下，就是在回声之子周围呢，也有不少因为钻探和挖掘而被发现的奇特景观，比如这处巨大的含有大量固态燃素的流金之脉，以及一些很神秘的可以一直向上挖掘的洞穴等等。
Just showed me the new Nutland characters. Okay, characters in this is different. Okay.
你刚才也说
no context like 2 years ago. I would assume it's River of Genshin.
做建长的。
I can see it on Kinich, but not on the rest, okay? Just because he has this pixely thing to me. But this looks like Genshin to me, man. I don't know what you're on about. This looks like Genshin. This looks like peak Genshin to me. Shark Girl 2? Nah, man. Shark Girl looks a lot like Genshin to me.
Oh.
I mean, I guess she's too dark for you or some shit.
小巴，那边还有一处好像是你们部落的。
是的，这是我的老家。
Dude, she's from Hawaii, man.
She
good.
看一下吧，
没问题。那你来带路。
Hawaiian girls are hot. And not obese.
这里呢，就是我的老家西欧龙部族。流泉之众，就咱部落的人呢，是大多是热爱音乐，
okay, yeah, the shark
然后以及喜欢泡泡温泉、休闲放松，然后包括他们的伙伴企鹅龙，
但 then again, also exists,
okay, so 甚至有那么一点迟钝的样子。虽然我们不
，a bottle also,
经常看起来是这么一副安逸的样子。但当遇到真正的战斗
，I mean it's just surfing animation，
也都是一把好手。
On Kinich, yes, okay, sure。
咱部族的人也是那少数的能够在液态燃素区域上活动的人。
That's hard to define. I would say she's very Genshin-y. It's much more cartoony. I don't know. I think Kinich seems enemy as fuck. Or like, not enemy as fuck, but Nintendo as fuck, if that makes sense.
其实也不用，因为液态燃素区域呢，它通常是在比较隐秘的地
下，或
者说存在在一些比较有挑战
，challenging zones，
需要喜欢挑战的旅行者们呢，自己前去体验。
我们两个都说差不多了，鸡哥觉得缺点什么？
那接下来就去看看我的老家，也就是孽龙的部族怎么样？
好呀，
行，那我来带路。
哎，这是什么呀？
嘿嘿，这可是孽龙部落的宝藏，也就是地图。 哎，既然大家看到了孽龙部族这边有一个这么大的孽龙头像，那不如我们就从龙本身开始说起吧。
可以啊，看一下跟我们疾风龙还有小八他们骑游龙究竟有什么不同。
没问题。那孽龙呢，它最强大的能力当然就是自己觅食的能力了。大家就看
见，在孽龙的甲带当中，其实储存
一种很特殊的叫做火流果胶的物质。
那
每当孽龙要去觅食的时候呢，就释放夹带当中的火流果胶，用它粘住果实，然后送入口中。那在纳塔当然也会有一些富含染素的果实，但孽龙呢，也可以通过火灵果胶去吸收这些带有染素的果实，并且在适当的时候去释放它们，造成爆炸的效果。
He understands the concept of Warcraft. Electro, I guess, could be, but I hope not. I don't need electro characters, man, and I want
Yansan.
So, I have
issues.也会和他们的龙伙伴一样，在群山当中来回穿梭。所以呢，孽龙部族，也就是玄木人部族的成员，他们多半也都是冒险家、运动员，或者说快递人这样的一些职业。
在孽龙部族旁边呢，
so, yeah,
其实有这么一个遍布高耸悬崖的遗迹。
I think he's Spyro.
和孽龙一起，
而且我
在说
no electro. I mean, no electro sounds actually fitting somewhat. I'm not gonna lie. No electro sounds more reasonable than no cryo. But I mean, we know we have cryo because we have the other bitch, the pinkhead bitch. Fake, what's her name? March, fake March. Probably doesn't make sense too, yeah. I mean, not having electro makes the most sense somewhat. Red Zara syndrome? Maybe. I hope not. Chef Grind in the corner. Nah, man. Chef
Babe.
The question is, when will Chef get a rerun? New boss, Glutinous. Oh my fucking god, it's a chonker. Oh my, look at the chonk. Chonk, man. Chonk. That's the chonkiest we have ever seen somebody being Genshin. Dude, that's our chonker boy. I don't want to fight him. It's a Denver chicken, but in obese. Hyper beam, yeah, boy.
一定没有。哎，对啊，那我还不得不说一句啊，这个孽龙的 boss 长须还是挺可爱的。
Yeah, no, I don't think so.
都是这种可爱画风。
Because double five step would be weird. It's a Snorlax with hyper beam. I mean, Snorlax learns hyper beam. Gold flame. There we go. That's a dragon.
其实也是我们五点零版本旅行者需要面对的一个敌人。
哎，但是我怎么记得纳塔的龙好像一般都是聚居的？为什么这只龙它会自己单独跑出来呢？
啊，你也看出来它跟我们现在我们三个是不太一
样的。Oh my
god！ 这只巨大的家伙呢是有一些特殊的原因呢。我拉你，哎呀！然后他不得已而为之，最后离开了自己的族群，生活在这片区域。
哎呦，我操！
除了刚才我们介绍过的这个
胖胖
的孽龙和神秘的大飞龙啊，
yeah, they,
我们在纳塔的旅程中还有许多神奇的生物，
they are
比如说看上去就很容易被撞飞的鸟，
top together, okay? It's not like they're actually made for each other.
看上去就很热的甲虫，还有一些看上去就很会飞的老鼠。
除了刚才老杨讲到的这些奇特生物以外呢？在纳塔还有很多风格迥异的场景，比如说神秘的高难度的夜神试炼，还有巨大的间歇喷发的火山，未来呢也会给旅行者们开放。
I mean, in that case, then you fucked up completely in Inazuma because that would be Yai because most of them are 5 stars, okay? Completely new to the reputation system. Wait. Can now visit Totem of
Paul
in each tribe? Oh shit, we have tribes? Reputation tribes? Nah, man,
this is big.
Freena is the best support for Nerf, even though the special forms are too different.
Yeah, I
don't know about best part here. And Raiden works too, I guess. Yeah, two Raidens. What the fuck, two Raidens?
也就是说，包含上述所有的内容在内，每一个部族都将陆续开放三个章节供玩家游玩。
所以我们纳塔的传说任务其实是换了一种新的形式出现的。
除了部落巨温以外呢，在 5.0 版
本
还有更多以单元形式出现的。
Maybe change completely. So,
with
the tribes after they are maxed out, we will not be able to do the not request but the other one, the bounties. And there are bounty achievements, so that's gonna be fucking weird, okay? I'm just saying. Name one character that buffs Nevelet damage more than Rina.
I don't care.
And it doesn't buff him directly, but indirectly. Are those
events?
Leyland Overflow, oh my god, I can't wait.
准备了一些特殊的游玩的短片。 具体有多不一样，我们一起看一下就知道。
好，那我们就看一看。
Let's check it out. Let's check what out.
带来了很多全新的玩法，今天也邀请了几个朋友到现场来实际体验一下。我就先带着大家跑一段现实挑战。这个地方有一个龙灵，这是
Sovereign Spirit Tribe, OK.
然后我们可以魂附到这个龙灵上，就可以开始我们的挑战了。
Oh my god, look at this. Oh my god.
我们需要借助我们这个小龙的特点啊，去尽可能多的吃到金币。
Dude, I like this shit, okay? Oh my god, and then we switch around? Oh no. Oh my god, he got skill issue.
这个地方呢又要切回我们几方龙了。
墙上这个红色的石头是
不能量的。
Oh.
Replenish your energy. Oh, okay.
还行还行。
厉害厉害。
S ring.
也就是101-101吧。
Okay, there are different ranks. That's interesting. Oh my god, the guy has mad skill issue. I see it. What the fuck is she doing? Okay, if you have seen, they get like 20 to 25% HP on fall damage. That's interesting. Wait, that's cool as fuck, boy. Oh my god.
那你要相信我，
你转头看看呗，
避都不了。
哎
哎，
我怎么感觉我下面又漏了
？OK，
准备到你了啊！来了。
Those seem very interesting, actually.
打开了元素视野，
不愧是我教的呀。
Elemental side, just to spoil us with where.
回到正轨。
What the fuck is he doing?Oh my god, that's major skill issue. That's like half of Reddit.
Oh.
B rank.
第一次嘛，还可以。最高评分应该是 B.
那必须的。Yeah?
Yeah, like this guy has massive skill issue.
逐渐减小。
攻击攻击。准备要接手了。交吗？
啊，怎么不换好给我？
加油加油
！She has less skill issue, but still somewhat of skill issue.
高阶操作了。
哎。
Okay, S rank, you don't need everything for S rank. Good to know.
一般一般，也没满嘛，对不对？原神5.0版本也即将上线，马上就给旅行者们端上来了。
Launch of Travel
Soon. 大家一起去纳塔去
体验这些新鲜的玩法。Yeah.
期待。
He seemed very hyper focused on the screen instead of the gameplay. So, I don't know. Kind of weird.
原神的国内市场负责人 Michael.
I guess she's not a gamer.
这次说来也巧啊。我们的五点零版本刚好撞上周年庆啊！
是哎，那说起周年庆，那就必须带上我们的传统技能。
Forget our transitions. Oh no, three pulls.
通过周年庆的签到活动，我们会为各位旅行者送出10枚资源。
嗯，
另外我们也会通过邮件向大家发放包括1600元。
Okay, ten pulls and ten pulls.
其中还包含一个全新的跟宠
，new pet gadget,
小道具哦。
那接下来必须还有
啊，
对对对，我们也会在这个版本去重置大家
的双倍
福利。
嗯，那福利的环节就到这里。那接下来要
介绍等等
等等等等
啊，
那福利的环节为什么就到这里了？
我们每年的福利不是都还有吗？
哎
，Oh my god！
难道大伟哥没有跟你讲过吗？
啊，他跟我讲什么了？
那么这个你见过吗？
这什么、啊、这么厚吗
Michael 你真不知道吗
真不知道
别慌别慌别慌那我们就带入 Michael 的
We get a free chi chi
一起来一条一条分享一下这个版本、做出的福利以及相关优化、在 5.0 版本期间旅行者们只要完成完成任务融花与炎日之主
以及主线和 5.0
的主线就可以在活动界面直接领取额外的500原石
刚刚说到的是完成主线就有更多的原石吗
没错、
okay. We get more premium gemming for
Aquaquest 还有提到一点是 5.0 版本期间才有那是只有 5.0 才有吗
Wait, we get
那可不是了
Wait
在接下来的 5.0 5.1、
okay.
和 5.3 版本
Wait 5.3
重要篇章发布的这些
5.3 OK Pyro Arco comes 5.3 OK Dawn you fucked up You fucked up Dawn you fucked up It's over It's over You're fucked You're done
魔神任务啊那接下来我当然要去讲一讲
They just spoiled it They just said it
在后续的新角色
Next quest will be 5.1 And then 5.3
So
Pyro Archon at 5.3 We have the information, we have the intel We know it all now Dawn's Cook, it's over
这些奖励包含额外的原石以及还有对应的角色突破等级2和突破等级3所需要的所有培养材料哦
就
拿 5.0 版本的马拉尼来举例子
First test run event
首先我们会有写示身手的活动马拉尼可以突破到突破等级1对不对然后因为马拉尼有不足技能
Wait, what?
也就是说接下来他会陆续获得突破等级2和突破等级3的所有材料
OK
也就是说玩家几乎不用付出任何的额外努力
We can now level 60 quickly
他就能直接将马拉尼快速升到60级
那
I like that
说明现在养新角
色的这个培养压力就一下
子下来了,
没错这样也是能够为我们的新老玩家第一次接触到新角色的时候就是能铺平很多原先遇到的阻碍
但是对于新加入的这些旅行者他们好像不能立刻赶到纳塔对于他们
Yes, they will because we get free teleport again
你的意思是说假如我是一个初来乍到的旅行者
对的
我没有办法
After finishing Moonshot main quest thing you unlock teleporter that brings you to Natlan Institute
后面呢我们也开放了一个新的功能是主线快速开启功能在 5.0 版本更新以后只要完成了里面的主线魔城任务并且达到了冒险等级
you have to finish
就可以直接
在
活动界面开启纳塔的
OK that's pretty fucking cool
那太好了就是之前还有一些朋友会问我嘛什么时候入坑原神最好那我觉得就是现在
了我还
要给大家补充一条信息哦就是快速开启的这个功能在后续版本也会陆续开启
那让我再追问一下吧之前忙碌在外的一些旅行者或许会返回到提瓦特大陆再看一看那对于我们这些回归的老朋友是不是也应该有些表示、啊、
Returning old players
你知道在原神与先的版本里面有一个针对回归玩家的活动叫新之归还对那么在 5.0 版本呢我们对新之归还的奖励也做了一定的调整除了原本的原始奖励以外呀还有一些长期没有回归到提瓦特的旅行者们那这些旅行者呢还会额外在新之归还活动中领取至多10枚纠缠之源
十抽啊
nice
对具体的参与规则呢
I think it's
可以参考后续的官方公告和游戏
内容指引 Another JPEG
等等那新玩家跟老朋友都照顾到了
没错、啊、
那像我这种一直坚守
在 Dude, this view goes for fucking long time I'm not gonna lie
我们也提了很多的优化意见跟想法那有没有针对我们的一些内容呢
那当然了我们一直在强调其实原神的开发组啊一直在持续的关注和倾听玩家的反馈那么接下来我们还有更多的调整和优化
Yeah, new world level for example Spoiler, I'm not really spoiler
只要旅行者们点击背包当中
对应区域特产的野外
采集选项
yeah,、we can now see
我不知道大家有没有注意过
where on the map
区域特产一直有一个 只可观看
local specialties
不可点击的
for character ascension
采集地点推荐
which is pretty neat
那么现在呢只要你点击了这个选项
but you don't see the exact place obviously because of the characters that have
不仅如此你还可以通过这个自动追踪功能来监控这些区域里面剩余特产的可采集数量
哇那也太舒服了吧那怪物的掉落的这个能不能也
Monster Drops will be buffed too for Spectres
我去收集这个海乱的一个漂浮灵的时候真的太痛苦了
那么在这一次啊我们也针对这样的一个反馈做了一些调整在 5.0 版本更新以后呢我们特定的一些怪物的材料掉率也会获得提升其中啊就包括 Michael 你刚才提到的海浪鬼和漂浮灵
那怎么样
There was something else Yeah it's Rune Guards and the other shit things
素材的对比啊
Oh my god Alexino they based with a weapon of course
他们的掉率可能还不能满足玩家锄大地的一个需求啊所以在 5.0 版本我们还推出了另外一个功能
我们推出了开放世界等级的世界等级九，
世界等级九。
Oh, there's a sentient quest for it.
那大家会想，世界等级九会不会非常困难？但是对于这些实力强大的旅行者，他可以很轻松的挑战世界等级九的这些内容的同时呢，还会获得更丰厚的掉落奖励。我必须要强调一下，这些掉落奖励呢，也包含首领敌人在内。
Yeah, we get now guaranteed three drops with a chance of four drops on boss fights. Okay. So if you want to upgrade your characters, usually we get 2 to 3, and now it's 3 to 4, which is pretty fucking good.
是可以叠加的吗？
没错，这两个效果是完美叠加的。所以 Michael， 你的理解能力很强啊！
哇，真那有点不得了啊
！Michael， 你已经听到这里了。难道你不觉得
那这样吧，我还有一些痛点，就我必须要今天就替玩家去说。圣遗物
Artifacts
觉得、
okay.
应该优化的。
Apparently I hear that there will be a new artifact system thingy、
就是、圣遗物啊，我觉得大家这么多年下来、
which will be OP as fuck.
对原神的圣遗物主要
是 I don't know
吐槽两个点、啊、
how it will
就是第一个点叫圣遗物转狗粮、第二个点叫
Oh my god, the double
dead one. 圣遗物的胚子。我们先说圣遗物分解的事情啊。旅行者们在分解圣遗物之前不是只能分解出摩拉吗？那么这次啊，我们分解圣遗物之后可以将它转化圣遗物的经验素材。也就是说大家不用再担心说
oh my god, nice. Okay, that's oh my god, finally.
而占大家的背包空
间。 This is so good.
我以前就是因为有一些
圣遗物词条和
传语词条不知道应不应该把它拿掉，所以我一直都存着。我的背包是满的状态，
对，然后存着的时候呢，你又不太愿意把它直接换成魔拉，
对，万一后面有角色要用到，那对吧？我也不知道。
没错。好，那刚才 Michael 其实提了一个很重要的问题啊，就是他如果到了关键的时候，却又没有办法为后续的角色获取对应的圣遗物，就会感觉自己很矛盾，
对
不对？对
的。
那么除了圣遗物转化为培养材料以外
，Another major feature. Let's go.
第二个很重磅的功能叫做。祝圣之
霜 Sanctifying Elixir OK
这个名字听起来有点厉害、
这个名字听起来很厉害它的功能其实更厉害
That doesn't look like an elixir
旅行者们可以通过使用祝圣之霜
Basically we can get two minor effects like crit rate and crit damage So we can farm specifically hydro damage with crit rate and crit damage
的属性种类还可以额外指定两个
副
词条的属性
This is strong OK
没错，
那我的双爆岂不是
跟你想的一样？5.0 版本的铸圣之霜，
nice.
大家可以通过萃取一定数量已经升级的圣遗物，或者说探索纳塔的大世界，或者说解锁我们的珍珠祭型，达到指定的等级来获取。
Oh, we get them from Battle Pass.
刚才我们是不是有提到周年庆的邮件奖励？
对。
所以在周年庆的邮件奖励当中，
okay, like,
我们也附赠了一部分铸圣之霜供大家取用。
周年庆的邮件居然有这么好的东西在吗？
没错。关于铸圣之霜的详细获取规则和消耗规则呢，后续也可以参照游戏内相关指引。
Okay,
我知道之前一直也有旅行者吐槽啊，觉得我们进行奖励的很多物品我已经用不上了，包括可能我已经溢出的锻造的魔矿，包括可能
哎
我在不同国家的角色呢，
他们的天赋等级已经都一样
满
了，
对，
你还在持续给我提供这个国家的天赋，是不是感觉很尴尬？
是的，
哎，那么从5.0版本开始呢，我们
的进行
奖励也会进行调整。
I hope not.
首先是在进行开始的时候，旅行者们就可以从四种
养成
资源中任选其中三种，作为本次进行可获取的奖励。也就是说，你可以通过自己的需求来查漏补缺了。此外呢，如果旅行者们解锁珍珠祭型或者珍珠之歌，并且在达到对应的等级后，我们原本指定国家的角色建构培养素材会变成能够让旅行者自由选择任意国家的角色天赋培养素材。
Guide of Conflict，
等等，
这个Guide to Conflict，
你现在说的真的是原神吗？
I really talk about Genshin Impact. Genshin could never.
为了去提升我们队伍的体力上限，他必须得把
，wait，
蒙德和璃月的齐天神像
，wait，stamina limit，
对不对
？Wait.
你觉得这个问题该不该解决？
对啊，不然玩家直接到了纳塔，或者说体验其他的
，every hundred level they get one. I mean, I wouldn't mind that too.
没错。所以既然我们做了主线快速开启，那么一定要把相关的所有的细节都优化到底。从 5.0 版本更新开始，旅行者们就可以通过供奉任意区域的神像来增加自己的体力上限了。与此同时呢，从纳塔开始，纳塔的七天神像
纳塔的地灵龛，还有类似像枫丹路径泉这样的纳塔独有的供奉系统，也将会提供更多的原始奖励。
OK，
我帮大家算了一下，上述这些原始奖励加起来的总和有超过十枚纠缠之源的价值哦。
More than 10 people gems. OK, good, good.
没错。
哇，我
Also, sun's coming out. It's problematic.
有点动力要。
I'm going to be disappearing more into butterflies and remember that.
结束了吧？
你希不希望？
你
希不希望这个？
不对不对，你这个眼神有点不对。你意思是还有吗？
哎，你看我手卡已经用完了呀。
是啊。
那当然是。
你还给我留了？
我还留有后手。
Oh my god, yes, more
people. 你要知道啊，或者我们的旅行者大家要知道，一般节目的高潮啊都要留到后面的。所以到迄今为止，我都还没有收到重量级的信息。
I haven't reviewed the most heavyweight. Wait, what? That was the small thing.
我说过，有这些东西啊。
This is a surprise.
这次我也不做，顺序安排由 Michael 自己去抽一张。
那我先抽这个吧。
先抽这个，对不对？你确定？
确定。
OK， 好。
What comes now?
刚才啊，我们有一位朋友说到过，希望他能够把玩家 Y 小老者
Who could transfer bad luck with 50-50
to himself? 转到他身上。
Nah.
我们也很佩服这位旅行者的勇气。但是接下来我要公布的这一项福利，可以些微的分担一下这位旅行者的负担。Michael， 你想不想替各位旅行者先体验一下？
Wait.
那我就替各位旅行者先验验货了啊。
Wait.
好，那么麻烦我们的工作人员。
Wait.
好，谢谢。
Weapon optimization, I wish.
好 ，Michael， 试试看。
Oh my God, got a 5-star, what a surprise!
这个特效怎么
？Wait, what the fuck is that?
不一样了呀，不会是我欧皇附体了吧？
这其实是我们在 5.0 版本的角色活动系统当中新加入的
Benny, of course, Benny.
叫做捕获明光
，Capturing Radiance.
这是什么东西？
我给你们解释一下。
Wait, what?
当玩家呀常说的小保底到来的时候
，The counter capturing radiance event. Okay.
当这次事件出现的时候呢，抽取的结果必定为当期的 UP 五星角色。
Maybe definitely promotional fighter.
我比较好奇啊，这个事件会挤占以前的大小保底的概率吗？
I'm confused.
知道你就会这么问，我相信旅行者们也非常关心这样一个问题。那么捕获明光，它关键就关键在它只是单纯提高了小保底抽中当期 UP 的机会。并不会影响这个游戏其他所有的概率规则，也就是说，你简单理解为我们抽中当期 UP 的概率提高了，就这么简单。
Okay, nice. But what does that mean in numbers? I need numbers, please.
更详细的信息会在后续的官方公告和游戏内的概率公式详情给大家一一说明。
那接下来
you probably notice, no, go fuck yourself, man. I don't want to wait.
都不算爆炸性消息是吗？
我觉得已经挺爆炸了。
不过呀，既然你都这么问了。我只能说
I wonder how high the chance is getting increased for that.
这三个消息中最不爆炸的一个，我们再试试武器神助
复兴
祈愿。
好，我点出去看看，
记得先定轨哦。
Optimize path.
不对吧？这个定
轨的数字好像
有点问题。
哪个数字有问题啊
？Oh my God, web beta fix.
你并没有
web beta fix, man.
从 5.0 版本更新开始，我们的神助复兴祈愿，也就是武器池，它的定轨上限会从2调整到1。
不会吧
？Oh my god！
对策划的印象，我觉得事情
Dude, this is so good. Oh my god, nice！
你看 ，Michael 的这个质问就非常的
，No more second grade magic。
但是我
Oh my god, no more third grade magic。
这一次武器的起源定轨，我们真的只是把它从二下调到了一，仅此而已。我们没有变动其他所有的原有的规则。我还有最后一条。更劲爆的消息。
Okay, so if I lose the 37% chance,
I'm
still good because I just need 160 pulls. At worst case, which is not reasonable, it's less like 77 times 2 only, but whatever. So, like 140 pulls roughly to get a weapon. That's actually good.
那么在今天呢，我在这里去公布
Find benefit.
我们这一次 5.0 前瞻节目的最后一条福利投放的消息。
Oh my God, what's coming on?
也就是从今年开始，每年《原神》的周年庆版本期间，我们都会向已经解锁了祈愿系统的所有旅行者
Any 5-star for free.
提供一次。
Nah, man, what?
奔行世间祈愿包含。
Oh my God, it's happening. We get a standard banner.
不仅是一个。
Oh my God, free day.
五星。 还是每年一个自
选？Oh my god! Sun gets fucking day up finally. Watch him
misclick. 应
该 talk 那音色。
很多人看到我们直播。
我说的很清楚。我
accidentally press on
the
loop because he's drunk as fuck. And he's like, oh my god, pyro claim. 都会给大家这样一个自选常驻五星的机会。Oh my god, this is actually cool.
我们的这个常驻词是一直加新角色。
We continue new characters in Zenobia.
随着我们版本的推进啊，其实会有越来越多的角色加入到奔行时间起源当中。也就是说，每年的这个福利也会随着版本的推进，它的选项会逐渐丰富起来。
Okay, so more standard banner characters come.
你觉得这个福利？
But explain, explain.
起来了，我今天。
Keep yapping. Keep yapping.
我。
Does that mean old characters? Like it would be reasonable at this point, okay? To put shit in, like I don't know. Let's say clear something. We don't have Jude's standard head, yes. Maybe we get Teferi. I don't know her name. Gilantan or some shit. I don't know.
原神这个游戏
的开发者，但
同时我们也是原神的玩家，这一点一直从 1.0 开始，我都在不断的跟大家传达这样一个信息。那么玩家提出的一切问题，我们作为玩家当然也都是
getting free standard banner fives
are every
year that I take it. That means I get my DR66 or my GG66 quicker.
我们能够一直走下去。
Why the fuck do I randomly wake up at 7 a.m. there's a fucking switch program? Because 5.0 patch.
就到了 Michael 的回合。
Also, that shit is live for 1 hour and 20 minutes already.
不如刚刚的惊喜，但是我们准备的周年庆相关
内容比往年还是
只多不少。我们想
Web Banner now only lets you lose the 75% bonds. Why so early? I don't know. I think some Chinese convention garbage.
我觉得项目组的大家其实都是
FES or some shit, something with Shanghai.
还是要以高品质的核心内容创作作为它最重要的基石。我们要持续不断地去做出好内容本身，这才是我们一直能够走下去的历程之本。
Okay, we can choose.
如果说我们
作为那个
没有让玩家、没有让旅行者感受到乐趣，
那一定是我们哪里出现
了问题。我们会非常非常乐意
去收集大家的看
法，进行调整。
七哥突然之间
，The system is the same shit. It just one fade point instead of two fade points.
有意思的短片来转换。
I don't really see how people will complain this year. People will complain. Why do we get another weapon for them as well?There you go. Why do we not get a limited 5-star? Just wait, man. People will complain. People always complain. And we get a fucking Natlan enemy. And it's fucking Majin Buu. Because he's pink. Medilan finally gets a perfect gobby. Yeah, and then it will roll shit because the other two stats will be flat defense, flat HP, and goes.5 times into flat HP, just to piss you off. Dude, I want Mualani so badly. I need Shark Girl. Dude, this is neat. It's pretty fucking cool animation, I gotta say.The capoeira lolly, man, I can't. Dude, this shit is way too funny. Blaze to Natlan, let's go. 420 Blazer, Genshin Impact. AT40 GDLRA 5E5.You don't have capitalization, you fucked up. What do you say? Most important stuff that's been announced, please. Raiden rerun, Kazuha rerun. We get free Geo Loli. Capitano, probably Cryo character. We don't know that for sure yet. There's a lots of quality of life stuff.The new 5-star character that is Dendro, Kinichi or some shit, or Kinich. He is basically Wanderer and better, as it seems like right now. Mualani seems to be extremely fast for Overworld Riding. And this is not a joke, she's writing a fucking chart.
并且啊，有很多玩家的建议，其实给了我们迭代的灵感。 所以我们从 4.8 开始就一直在对这个玩法进行调整。那在接下来即将更新的 5.0 版本当中呢，我们全量重新设计了玩法当中的奇妙注意事件。那在新的版本当中呢，这些事件将根据当期的参数进行有效清晰的策略引导。现在开始 play again，I don't know man，注意的时候就应该什么样的队伍使用了。
Just find YouTube videos summarizing it later. It was really a lot. It was really a lot. Also, I will upload it to YouTube once this thing is done. So again, hello YouTube. Follow, subscribe. And please like the video, give a comment on
shit. 即使玩家对自己手头能够出战的角色机制不够了解，他也能够简单的通过元素搭配。
Except for Last Traveler Story, since we were released. No, I'm not nice to you, okay?
那当然了，可能会有玩家会问啊，那如果你们设置了这么强大的，其实这些玩法越发的没有挑战性，所以在5.0版本呢，我们对于追求更高难度的挑战者也会开启新的。Wait,
there's another. Oh my God, 26. Wait, more rewards? No! Oh no, they make it
harder.没错。此外呢，在5.0版本，我们还会有一些老朋友，七夕召唤卡牌当中，那新的角色卡、新的怪物卡以及行动牌也会独家收集，还会有新的纳塔牌背等待大家获取哦。另外还有联动活动要跟大家分享。
Not gonna have it, but
sure.
Touch of Fate.
Logitech
G Hub, wait, what? Okay, wait. If we get Ayaka themed mouse, that could be actually looking fucking amazing. Not gonna lie. Because the color scheme. That could be depending. Maybe. That one could be very interesting for me. And I hate Ayaka. I can really full Logitech G setup, possible. Also, if you have seen the chair had some Ayaka Gaoshi. Have a tic-tac-toe board on hand. Nice. I mean, it probably is. Imagine a mouse pad of her fucking forehead. The biggest mouse pad in existence. It's like a fucking table, okay? Not a banger? Okay. Time to turn up my fucking volume. Okay, look. Okay, I'm saying something very controversial now. Okay, so please close your ears. Twitter should not be complaining. They have the melanin on stream right now. Who is racist? Yeah. Life is racist? Yeah. I am racist. I like cars a lot. German? I mean, yeah, that's like basically the same thing. I wonder if anybody on Twitter will complain there are not enough white people now on stream. I wonder. Probably not, right? Bro, it's Twitter. I know, but still. I want it to be happening. If not, I will be the one that meme complains on Twitter. I don't give a fuck. Like, why is everybody getting blackwashed? I would just say that shit. People will... It will be furious. It will be amazing, man. Dude, they will be bitching hard, man. Especially the white American college students that would be complaining, man. How you blow up, I guess? Maybe. No one trend increase? If you don't have positive, it probably. I will not remember these lyrics, I'm just saying. But it sounds kind of banger, not gonna lie. Nutland music will be amazing, okay? Hear me out. Nutland music, I will be fucking hyped about. Also, that's battle music. And it sounds banger. I want to battle, man. I want to fist fight some people. In Nutland, of course. Para Archon just fist people, yeah. I mean, that's like Dea, but she's not Para Archon, I'm just saying. Spoiler. Dude, it wouldn't okay, I have a bold prediction. Somebody on Twitter will be complaining, why are there white people in the black people's music. It will happen. It will happen. The most fucking racist, wild thing they could fucking imagine, they will say it. I guarantee it. I hope. Dude, I hope it, man. I really want to see it. Just for the meme. This thing does shit on the damage for her, obviously, I guess. I mean, maybe she's into that shit. I mean, I wish she would be like Sis Goleon from what's it called? Black Clover. But probably not. That's pretty good. It's fucking bright as fuck. Dude, the sun is annoying right now. But I can't stand up, there's no way. I'm locked to the screen. Rude? Yeah, fuck you, son. You're in the way. Your cock blocking my view to the orchestra. Dude, I can't wait, man. Music-wise, this is giving me Sumeru vibes, okay? Like, it's gonna be banger. Anthem of the Savannah. 100%. I was talking about white people and black music. Dude, it will happen. Dude, it will happen. People will complain about this, trust me. They'll be talking about cultural appropriation. Meanwhile, the actual people, let's say, should be offended. I hope that stuff is getting big out of audience, yeah, probably. Dude, I saw like two Mexicans complain about it, but they didn't give much fucks about it to actually complain about it. They would be like, yeah, they're kind of disappointed, but it's whatever. Mexicans. It's not even the targeted audience. It's Mexicans, man. Nobody cares about Mexicans. Sorry to say that, but Mexico is probably not in Nutland. Okay? It seems to be more on the southern side of South Africa. Not South Africa. South America. So it's gonna be like something like Argentina. Some shit like that, probably more like. That being said, that would probably like include like chili con carne or some shit. So it's at least Mexico will be somewhat part in there, but it will have no focus on visual representation or some shit. The targeted cause to make taco, that's true. I don't know what Mexican culture really is, to be honest. Aren't they pretty diverse? They have a holiday, which is, I think it was them, or it was Brasilia. It was one of the two, but I think it was Mexico. Which is basically they wear skulls everywhere and show skulls everywhere to honor the deceased or some shit. It's pretty fucking hard to explain. I know there was something like that, but I don't know exactly what it was about or what's called. That's more American than Mexican. No. Taco is, the origin is probably not even there. The origin is probably even Brazilian or something. Cinco de Mayo. I don't know what the fuck you just said. Piñata is Mexican. Piñata sounds about right here. Day of the Dead. Yeah, exactly that one. That one is a pretty big thing. And Ian's son most likely resembles that part. So it wouldn't surprise me if that's somewhat included in there. But I think they celebrate the same thing in Brasilia as well. So it could be maybe both. Sup, Mookie? How's it going, buddy, dude? Hope you have a nice day, my god. You missed the entire stream, my G. I'm just saying. I mean, Mexico is North American. Yeah, I know. But it also has, I think, a tiny little bit part on South American continent. I could be wrong, obviously. I'm not too sure. Where the continent landscapes are, like, colliding or not. So, don't blame me if I don't know it, okay? But it's gonna be fucking high, okay? I can't wait, man. Also, now that you mentioned taco, maybe I will eat tacos on that day on stream, okay? By the way, Chris, 24-hour stream on Nathan release, 28th. Just saying. In case you find a few minutes. I will be exploration. I am doing the exploration. I'm good. Wear sombrero. That's a good idea, man! Okay, bring it on, man. Okay, write it down. Suggestions on Discord. Write down. Taco, sombrero. What else we have? I'm not entirely satisfied with my performance, yeah.
Fair.
Sombrero with headphones might be tough. Nah, man. Trust me, I will make it work. I need a fake stash as well, but I'm not doing that for 24 hours. It's not going to be happening, man. Maybe I can do one of these challenges again. Where people can donate for like a week or some shit, channel points to eventually see it coming. Then I draw in a fucking stash. Just a real stash. Yeah, man, of course. With my beard growth, that's not gonna be happening, man. Unless you want to wait until 2025. Like, dude, I shaved a week ago? No, more. 2 weeks ago, probably.
Edit. Nightmare,
man. I'm Captain Redbeard right now. But the poor man's version, the one after chemotherapy. Gilgamesh and Honkai Star Rail and Pimp's Mustache in 1 week. Yeah, sounds about right. Even though I have no idea what happens in Star
Rail.
Come on, here's the video, I guess.
那旅行者前往寻找自己血亲的这个旅途，实际上也会和这个世界之间的联系，因为上述的原因越来越紧密。
Oh my God, 3-5 star! I will get.
期待，我们今天的前瞻特别多，到这里呢也就接近尾声了。那原神到现在啊都已经四年了，我也有很多心里话啊，想跟我们旅行的讲。我们一起从2020年的那个秋天启程呢。
I mean, you will get there, let's be real, man. If not, you're inting, but maybe you're trolling and you get Mona or some shit. Get a Chi-Chi.
Kishin66, that's a good idea. 有的把原神啊贬得一无是处啊，这样的声音多了啊，难免让我想。Also,
they mentioned absolutely fucking nothing.
我自己回想起原神这一路走来啊，其实旅行者的热情，与反馈，与动力啊，也是原神啊能够不断进步的动力。I mean,
they have to bring it back, but maybe they do it by extremely rarely.
原神相部组和我决定去跟世界各地的旅行者面对面聊聊。
I should meet with the way once in my life, man. That's probably not going to be happening ever. The way, if you see that, give me a call. Import me. I'm there.
有的呢只是新版本更新上来体验一下，有的呢已经很久没有来过提瓦特，跟他们聊完呢，制作组和我重新理解了旅行的意义啊。
But the,
我们的脑子里啊想起了那句啊，我们终将重逢啊。我们意识到啊，只有对旅行者的陪伴是原神唯一不能改变的。
I just kind of hate that Monroy getting like hardcore nerfed basically.
也正是因为有了各位旅行
者，by Kinich being a fucking character,
在未来带来更多精彩优质的
内容。Like this is somewhat annoying for me.
最后呢
，But then again, Mulani probably already called Gibson. Also, she's a catalyst user. Guess what? I can give her the thing as well. Use her for movement.
前去探索。
That's actually pretty amazing.
感谢大家一直的支持与
陪伴。Oh yeah, also Chris. There's no fire traveler. No pyro traveler on release.
旅行者们，我们纳塔见。
See you in Nutland. 24 hour stream. They're saying 28th August. Just 2 weeks. It's kind of weird. Yeah, it's somewhat weird. But it has lore reasons.We figure out why that is.
我感觉他们很
放松。Things starts,
比我们之前这个。
Once the play starts.
我在场的时候要轻松很多。
鸡哥怎么回事？都不提前跟我商量一下。还有不是跟我。
Also these on these, I want one of them.
怎么整的是我啊
？I mean they're not really on these, but.
啊，我不知道，我都不知道，我只是杨叶龙，你不要来找我，是大尾龙要我干的，要找大尾龙去啊。
It's really because.
不在时候他们谈笑风生。
The only time people use travel usually early patch, that is true. Like I would do it for.
我就看你还修不修你吧。
What's it called?
修完了。
走走走，赶紧回去修 bug。
Obvious reasons, I guess. Like, it's more interesting. Tevat Talks.
Hello, travelers.
Oh my god.
Welcome to Tevat Talks. I'm Zach Aguilar, voice of
Means to understand
Ether,
elemental resonance thingy better. That's true.
My friend and voice of Albedo, Koi Dao.
Huh? Friend, huh?
The best friends.
Like, Albedo, reminder he exists.
Trace without me.
Hey everyone! Genshin Impact invited us to be part of the 4th anniversary celebration this year.
Gay. Pretty much.
4 years. That's crazy. Wow, I can't believe it's been so long. These past 4 years, I've had the pleasure of delivering some epic grunt sounds as either
epic grunt sounds, that is true.
Emotional dialogue in the Archon Quest.
Windblade!
And working on the special programs.
Wetblade!
So many great memories have been made not only working on the game, but also playing it. What do you think, Koi?
Oh my gosh, 4 years.
Also, I hope.
Wow. You know,
officially
I turned 4 years old once.
Please.
That was awesome.
Koyo. So,
back then,
Megan.
I never thought I'd get to voice such a cool and intelligent character in an exciting game like
this. I want official chibi with
you know
some cute faces or something that I can make into emotes.
Sometimes truly
totally not a selfish thing to do, but
so let's Moist bring Blade a few special
deals critical damage.
To,
yep.
As Albedo might say,
you could say it's Moist critical.
Let's do it.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Happy 4 year anniversary,
it's
everyone!
It's Kuisa Dotali.
I'm Kimberly Ann Campbell, the voice of Nahida. And I know what you're thinking. A lot of people are like, wow, you sound so different from Nahida.
That is, she's actually one of the best VAs in the game just because of her voice range.
The voice of Nahida. So both online and in person at conventions, I get a handful of people who seem to be very surprised that that voice comes out of my body. What can I say? It's just what I sound like. I usually whip out a everyone hold hands to prove I'm
Dude,
not lying.
It's crazy, man. Like, the voice range
yeah,
she has
that's
is
super relatable.
Fucking
like,
insane.
I usually just scream Windblade at people to prove that it's
Windblade.
Me. Or make a huh sound.
Or even just in your private moments.
Yeah.
I've heard you scream it.
Exactly. I turn to my right side and I scream Windblade!
Windblade!
It helps scare away the demons.
That's weird. You're a weird guy.
Anyways, here's more guests.
Dude, if I had one of these iconic voice lines, I would be using it constantly.
I'm so lucky that I get to see a lot of Genshin Impact fans and cosplayers, especially the Red and Shogun.
Oh my god, it's Red Shitgun.
At conventions all over the world.
She said it was the grunts. Dude, if it was about the grunts, it would be the other guy, the Honkasare guy. I don't know the name anymore.
Oh yeah, that's me.Can you do a line? And I'll be like, Inazuma shines eternal. And watching their eyes light up always makes me smile. Genshin Impact fans are so passionate.
The eyes light up just like the Archons if guys. They use souls. I'm just saying.
I personally have
no. To celebrate. Don't say the line, please. Oh my god.
My life began to change.
If he says that line, way. I'm no.
I began to meet more I'm and more waiting. People online at conventions, and honestly, in my daily life, who are so passionate about this game.
Just don't say the line.
And I've learned that I love to sneak up on Genshin Impact cosplayers, and then when I'm right behind them, say something like, "This is an age."
Okay,
of gods
thank
and
God.
Monsters.
Thank God.
I wish not for dominion.
Oh my
god. Yet I cannot god. Watch the common folk suffer.
Thank God. I'm so happy.
Are genuinely priceless.
Dude, if you would have said the line,
I frequently hear from people online that that was one of the highlights of their con. I meet people
dude.
That are so excited about this game that they
That would be foul, man.
Out.
That would be foul.
I mean, honestly, how lucky am I to be a part of something like that?
Aw, that's so sweet.
Wow. No.
And that is such a funny
We're
thing
not
to do at
shit.
Conventions.
No.
Can you imagine
seeing no
people and
no
and someone speaking
it's
in voice?
It's
except I just get really shy.
Yeah.
Who else we got?
Okay, first off, I want to give a big thank you to the team at Genshin
Impact
for letting me
dude,
play
if
the most
Archons,
beautiful man
Freena wouldn't be there,
seen.
Okay?
Seriously, Nouvellet is
but
a
Nouvellet makes more sense because he's
one
Hydro
so
Dragon
excited
Sorry.
To play and dig into for years to come. Well, he does have a range of subtle emotional beats and some true cathartic.
Also,
twists.
His voice is completely
Nothing
different.
About him
it's actually surprising right now.
Compared to the elephant seal in the room.
Wouldn't be there either. Yes, because Hydro Dragon Sword Rain.
The mechanic Denali's Cardinal changed my life forever.
Yeah, of course he did. Say that
Genshin
word,
Impact
of course.
Fans are so polite whenever I meet them. Okay,
trees.
Never asked me to say it, but of course I always do. And their gratitude about he said the thing is
yeah, he
always
said the
a
thing.
Palpable delight. All right, let's do it. Oratrice mécanique d'Amélie's Cardinal. Thank you.
The best. The, that's
he
that's
the thing.
Man.
He said the thing.
He did say
he
the
said
thing.
Thing.
You
man.
Say the thing.
Wonder if this is a PR move because so many VAs spoke out during the first reveal. No, it's just because of the Genshin birthday, which is
so who's the most
in the next patch as well.
You've ever seen, Zach? There's a correct answer.
Because guess what? 6 weeks and September 28th. Mm-hmm. 29th, 27th, something like that.
I knew.
It's Genshin birthday, so they do that right now.
The most beautiful man I ever saw was the reflection in your eyes, me!
I knew it. I knew it. I knew that's where it was going.
Hair flip.
Well, that was fun.
Yeah, thanks for coming, everybody. And
okay, they ignored Benti.
Awesome
Benti's not an Archon confirmed.
Genshin Impact.
So much happened.
Yeah.
We've got some surprises in store, so stay tuned for other Teyvat Talks.
Teyvat
oh.
Talks.
Oh, there are more Teyvat Talks. That's right. Pretty good. Okay, I hope so. Yoimiya. Oh my god, Yoimiya. Lumine. Clorin, sadly too, but...
Welcome to Teyvat Talks. I'm Sarah Miller-Cruz, the English voice...
Also,
of
if Yoimiya is there, then
me
that means, son, you're wrong, because
Crystal
she's part of the drama. I heard.
Hi, everybody. Crystal Lee here.
So she's
I voice
not very based.
Legendary champion duelist herself. Pew, pew, pew. Ooh.
Hello. It is me. I have returned. It is Jenny Okobori.
So
was
that
being?
Was
it? So, and I hope okay. this anniversary sparks joy with all of you
ah,
out there.
So, yeah, then maybe. Then there's a chance.
The
but then again, I don't know. Did
the
Villette VA?
This amazing milestone?
I would have
oh,
hit that problem.
Milestone.
My D
years?
Isn't working
like
today. Well,
I mean, I'm gonna
oh my God,
dude, you're coming to that age where this is becoming a standard,
yeah.
Okay?
Don't
worry
anyway,
about it.
You,
it will just stick like that. It will just fucking be over. Okay.
But I'm sure I'll play more Genshin Impact as usual.
Only to remember Beidou and Sucrose. I remember Yoimiya only. Because
no,
that was a very huge disappointment for me when I heard about it.
4 long years. Okay.
No dick, no brain. Yeah, that's basically how life works.
So, I mean, listen. So, Crystal, you mentioned that you're going to graduate. I think I'm going to
yeah.
enroll in grad school so I can stay here for as long as I can.
Yes.
I'm enjoying
sure.
my time.
Because that's the best move. Get that PhD.
Yeah.
Get that postdoc.
I am very much a person that is motivated by sweet little treat culture, and so mm-hmm. I just want to know when my next sweet little treat's going to be, and oh, so yeah. I think I want to indulge in a cake. I want to get one of the Genshin Impact birthday cakes that they send you on your birthday. It's 4 years of looking at them, and I want one.
Yeah.
Oh, wait.
My God, about time.
Wait.
Anyway.
Why does she never play on her birthday?
Okay, no more.
I mean, yeah, well, that's on her.
Occasion.
I will get all the cakes. I'm going to be the cake archon.
Happy anniversary, Genshin Impact.
Okay, that's surprising. I like it.
I'm so humbled to be part of such a vast world and talent.
Oh, she says the line too.
When I auditioned for Chiori, I felt such a connection to her inner strength as a fellow AFAB business owner who is
Chiori fucking hottie.
They are intimidating.
Who she wants everyone is what she said. Oh, okay.
And who has big
Did
aspirations?
She? I don't know.
Throughout the recording,
I only hear
Chiori
half of it.
Continued to inspire me.
I'm too busy speaking
bold,
myself.
Individualistic style.
The cake in the game is not a real pimp.
I hope to have brought a bit of me.
The cake
to
is
you
real. The cake is not a lie. Son, stop.
Oh,
okay,
that
stop.
Is so sweet.
Wait, that's
I
lovely.
Love that.
The
love
cake
Britney.
Is never a lie. Will never be a lie.
That is so great.
That's an amazing answer.
And
I
now,
really
please, where's Fish Lady A?
Genshin Impact shows
Oyo?
A lot of really strong women. You know, like a business
yes.
owner is like
you think about
being one
exactly.
such example. That's amazing.
Yes.
Don gets it.
Yes. Oh my gosh. And I feel like a lot of us do feel
Dude, this
connection.
This video
to
goes for 2 hours almost already.
What I think.
That's a pretty
you know, like,
big preview.
Really connect
this time.
Them
yeah.
to life. You know what I
yeah.
mean? I feel like I'm a lot like Lumine because I also have a twin brother in real life.
Yes.
Yeah.
Also, you're
so
a cutie, Lumine. So I guess
we
you're
are
in real life cutie too.
In
before
like,
Oz, but no fish. I would take that as well, dude. For me, that would be
honestly,
win.
Honestly,
but then
I
again, that's not gonna be happening if it's
basically every
it's
single time
both on nobody.
And Lumine getting to be together again.
Probably.
I really cannot.
It's either only
Fischl
or it's
separated from my
Fischl and Oz.
Makes me so emotional.
My dear familia.
It's one of the reasons that. When our amazing director was giving me direction for the opening cutscene where they get separated, it actually made me cry.
Oh,
the end.
I love to laugh, if you can tell. And I love to laugh as Farina, especially. Some of my favorite booth moments involve doing her variety of laughs. I also kept cracking up later on when she
I'm not surprised that she's in
shouts,
there too.
Action! I had so much fun doing those in a variety of ways, and I'm so happy the team liked the variety and even some of the silly
also
like
that they take the
no
long
ones.
Hair Farina as
the, other side
the
spectrum,
picture instead
of
the short haired
one.
One
of my
favorite Venti, that is a very good
Farina
question.
Was on stage. Reliving all those
But again, he wasn't in the Archon section
the current day.
Or the
I'm
representation of areas
stop crying in the
one.
While recording those.
So
legit.
He will
Tears
not appear probably.
For days.
Or she will not appear.
Oh.
Because it's a female VA.
That's a lot of tears today. That's a lot
oh
of
my gosh. I know. I guess everyone's talking about things that made them emotional.
Right. Gosh.
I'm just like, I'm gonna keep saying this because just because I love so much of our cast, but I'm like, I love Amber and
yes,
also,
she's amazing.
Like, it's very true. Like, she does love to laugh. She's a close
Oh,
friend
that
of mine,
Amber.
I
was confused for a second.
So I feel like Farina was just made for her.
And he though, yeah, he's
the way
just
that
not
a
there.
Lot of people match up with
know.
Their characters and relate so well, it's one
it's
of
weird.
The most incredible things.
They should have put
and like seriously, Farina
Venti together with Dongli, Raiden, Nurette and that
Absolutely.
Shit. He should have been in that part
oh
of the
gosh.
Thing, but
well, okay.
It's not though. It's
I mean,
there.
That's
I don't
a question
know.
Though. What about you, Jenny?
Okay, so I mean, my first job when I moved out to LA was actually being a pyrotechnician.
Wait, no way. Are
yes,
you serious?
That's amazing.
What?
I had such a blast, pun fully intended, by the way, at that job, and it really helped shape who I am. And I honestly feel
that's
like
that's pretty neat,
Yoni
actually. That makes
it
pretty fitting for the voice.
It definitely feels like fate. Our similarities even like go beyond working with fireworks too. Yoimi and I are extremely bubbly and very talkative, as you guys have probably picked up on by now. however,
and we love
I think,
you both for it.
Thank you. However, I think the most meaningful similarity is the love we both feel for our disabled fathers. My father has since passed, but I grew up as the primary caretaker for my father who had Alzheimer's. So seeing Yoimi interact and help her father really struck a chord with me.
Yeah.
I'm getting a little bit choked up.
Oh,
I love her so much. Yoimi honestly means more
like,
than
they're extremely fitting, dude.
Articulate.
They basically
so
made the character
friends,
after her at this
like,
point.
Present company included, because of this opportunity that I've gotten to voice her, including her Japanese voice actor, who I got to meet last year, and she was so, so lovely.
Oh, amazing! Oh my God.
I think I saw the video about them meeting.
World through conventions. Yeah. It's such an unbelievable honor to lend my voice to Yoimiya, who's just like, who's a character that just brings joy to so many people all over the world.
You do such a beautiful job of
yes.
it, too.
That is true. Yoimiya is precious.
When I was cast as Venti,
there we go.
I was like,
there we go, Venti.
I'm so excited to be a bard. Because
okay,
I
Venti's not an Archon.
Yay.
Confirmed. Once again.
So Feathervine Laserfest, Venti keeps talking about how he's rehearsing this big song and that he's going to perform it at the end of the event, and he keeps saying the word song. So when we got to that final performance, I was like, hey, just for funsies, since we're running ahead of schedule, can I do a version where I sing at the end just for fun? And the team was like, sure, if you can come up with a tune really quick, we can do it just for fun. So I went on break for like 5 minutes and came back with a little tune for the lyrics and then recorded it in one take. It was super fun, but I didn't expect them to actually use it in the game because, like I've said 5,000 times, it was just for fun. And so when the event came out and people started excitingly tagging me in posts about Venti singing, I was so shocked and so excited. Oh my gosh. And it was just so sweet to see how much Venti singing meant to the fans.
Yeah, Venti singing is like,
so
that's needed.
And
okay.
I was so happy.
Having that in the game is always neat.
I'd love to sing in the game for another event sometime.
I wonder if other localizations
know,
have it.
I'm also happy to go back to his pretty poetry too.
I don't know. I'm actually
really
don't know.
Happy that I got
there's
to
a chance
sing
that they don't.
At least once in the game.
Or they adapted the other languages after the English one.
Oh,
that
yeah.
would be amazing too.
What? That's
oh my
incredible.
Gosh.
She just came up with the tune, like
yes,
spontaneously, just there,
right on the spot.
That's
I love it.
That's Erica for you. I mean,
I know,
like, listen.
I know.
Girl,
and
like,
I don't know
if y'all have heard the Venti song from that event, mm-hmm. but it is so good.
I don't remember it. I'm honest with
an
you, but
job.
That's incredible. One
she's
take,
so
5 minutes.
She's so stinking talented.
Just,
she really is.
She's so talented.
That's crazy.
I know. I know.
Oh my
well,
gosh.
Okay. So we've been hearing about how all these people feel like a connection to their character, and I was wondering, Crystal, if
oh.
you have an answer to that.
I have the feeling you're not official.
Juicy.
I mean, yeah,
I'm getting annoyed. I'm just
I think
saying.
One of the things that really brought me so close to Clarand was when I found out she was a secret nerd. Like
yes.
the second I found out she plays tabletop, and like
I don't think
tabletop with her friends. Like
they haven't realized yet
like,
that.
That's crazy.
Electro characters, they are all nerds.
Like, hey,
okay.
So, I don't know if you know about tabletop.
Like, all of them.
or
I don't
like,
think there's an exception.
You know, certain games involving tabletop. And I was
yeah.
like, are you kidding me?
React Andy, Venti song, oh my god.
I love it so much. And so
sure
to be able to bring
sure.
that side to her was just so incredibly fun. And I loved connecting with how much she, like, she's secretly super, super friendly. Like, you don't
yeah.
expect it when you meet her. She's, like, super stoic.
Mine
like,
is a fest.
Yeah, down to
it
business,
was mine
but
is a fest, yeah.
secretly, she's just out here loving her friends and, like, supporting people. And, yeah, I don't know. I loved that aspect of her. She just felt, she really came alive when I found that much more about her personal life beyond
yes.
her role in the court. It was so much fun. And
that's so
yeah,
cute.
I love
that.
Her so much. Thank you.
Oh my gosh. Well, it's been so great to hear from all these different actors. I've loved this. This is great.
This is
so
really
much fun.
Fun.
I know. I love hearing about how everyone connected, like, personally. It's like that
the
little
cock
backstage
me again.
Glimpse that you don't usually get.
Yes.
A little
yeah.
peek behind the curtain, if you will.
Exactly.
Yes. And I still can't believe it's been 4 years.
Also,
I feel like no time at all has passed somehow.
They didn't
like,
use a single four-star character.
It's so surreal. It really
in the
Tevet
Talk so far. It's all 5 stars.
Well,
oh my
hey.
Gosh.
Did you notice?
I mean, well, this has been great.
Or is it just me?
I've had so much fun with y'all today.
Same.
Also, the sun comes out, as you can
and
see, and I'm blinded
next,
as
so,
fuck
I mean,
now. I'm
hey,
blinded.
Everyone,
yeah.
stay tuned
I see
for
nothing.
More, and happy anniversary, travelers.
Yes,
stay
happy
tuned.
Anniversary.
Woo!
Happy anniversary! Woo! Oh my god, Sainu and Risley. Oh no.
Hello everybody, this is Alejandro Saab, voice of Sino, and thanks for tuning in to Tevet Talks.
Hey everyone,
Don
Joe Zee,
voice fucking
of Risley here, wishing
everybody dark mode
a
now.
Happy Genshin Impact 4
he starts to bark at the screen.
Yeah, same. Dude,
it is a very long
been
segment,
four
man.
4 years, oh my gosh. I remember when the game first started.
But
and
all
I was
5 stars,
like,
man.
I have no idea what I'm doing.
Every
and
5 star show,
like,
dude, wouldn't surprise me. But then
there
must show Fisher 2. Since Fisher has
a
demo, and guess what? Only
I think, like, when
5 stars
I stream
after
the game, it's mostly
especially
on
early game.
I don't know what I'm doing at all.
So,
it's been it's been awesome to get to know the fan base and the game. And it's just this Genshin Impact has become this whole massive world. Like, who could have imagined?
Yeah, it's crazy.
Yeah, so I totally get it. So, without further delay, let's check out what our voice actors have to say about this landmark occasion in our journey.
Who comes now?
Hi, Father. I'm Erin Yvette, the
it's
English
Daddy.
Voice of
Jim
Daddy,
gets on Terra Talk, I can die peacefully.
Oh, a.k.a. Father. We've
unlikely.
Many
if
Fisher
is not happening, then he will probably
really
not be happening.
I'm quite fond of, but I think the ones that I recall most warmly
also, I think Hoyo forgot about Chonyu. Just like me, I swear to God, she just reminded that me that he
exists. In those few intimate moments with her children or with Claire V, I knew we made something special while in the booth, but oh boy. Watching the finished sequences with all the other actors' performances in there instantly made me so proud
that
to
was
be a part of this cast.
I gotta say.
And yes, it's also quite fun to play her viciously cool and aloof yet badass sides too. So thank you all for letting me be a small piece of this huge narrative adventure and for being such an incredible and welcoming community. Congrats on 4 amazing years, Genshin. Here's to many more.
Yes, Father.
Man, Arlecchino is so cool, and I absolutely adored that story. It was
that story's
dark,
fucking amazing.
And it was just sad at times. But you know, a lot of work goes into building the voices for these characters, you know?
Yeah, and sometimes like you don't know what the work's going to be until you get there. One of my favorite lines of Risley's is, if the Duke wants somebody dead, he needs no justification. And a lot of people don't know that it's one of the first scenes we ever did in the booth. And I remember thinking like, whoa, this guy's like rough. He's a prison warden. He's over here saying he's above the law. Okay, I guess you know, we'll play him tough, right? We'll play him really rough. Then it turned out that he was this really intelligent, respectable, even like kind man. Yeah. And so I just
and
to
he
take
likes
that
the Melusine Dotelius
you know,
world
kind of right out the gate, and then apply it to his otherwise really formal language. He speaks really intelligently, but he's also got this kind of like blue collar spirit that makes for a super interesting mix. It was just one of those fun experiments.
He's not hot, he's sleep deprived. That's a difference.
Yeah,
though.
Moments like that are absolutely awesome, especially when portraying these characters that have so
as
many
as you can see on the mark under
so
his eyes.
I mean,
motherfucker never slept in his life.
We got to see so many layers.
That's
of
how
Sino,
I feel.
You know? We're so used to him being nice to his friends after so many patches in Genshin Impact, you know? Like, he's like, oh, let's play Genius Invocation.
No, let's play
like,
Genius Invocation.
A random joke.
Yeah, okay, Sino.
It's cool that we finally got to, you know, a nice reminder that he's still the general Mahamantra.
Yeah, and it, like all of us have our own little stories
he's bold,
about how we came to it. We're all really unique. So let's see how some others. Spent
I think
the time
his rope is pretty good.
Yeah,
but I don't know.
First of all,
Navia,
congratulations on 4 years, you cute people. I mean, wow, I have been part of the incredible Genshin Impact universe for almost exactly a year
release,
now.
Release, Navia.
And let me just say, I was instantly hooked. From the talented team at miHoYo and our voice directors to the hardworking studio
I'm
crew
also cute,
and
son. Imagine.
The players around the globe.
But people on YouTube will be like, yeah, nah, man, fuck. She lied.
Energy tying us all together.
Shut up.
When we started our records and I dove into Navia's
then
emotional
I'm like
roller coaster
goblin.
Of a backstory, I knew that this
soulless ginger
special.
Goblin.
I mean,
it's Jova,
the loose
man.
And
it's
silver
Jova.
Still make me tear up just thinking about them.
Oh, man. Silver and Malus. I miss those guys. They were so cool. They were funny, but man, good times.
I can't wait to meet him. I haven't gotten to that part of the game yet, so before we get any spoilers, let's hear from Amber and Stephanie.
Yeah. Amber and Stephanie, who?
Congratulations!
Oh, okay, that Amber.
Four-year anniversary.
Another 5-star.
This year has been the most exciting for me, because I get to be a part of a game that transcends not only story and beauty, but also a great community of players.
I still
Emily
think Emily has one of the best designs in the game.
She's calm during
it's only going to be 5 stars. I swear to God, it's only going to be 5 stars. There's not even a fucking idea or thought about any 4-star character so far.
I knew she had to be mature enough to have the smarts and kind
advertisement,
enough to
care it seems
brothers.
Like.
Her character impressed me every day in the studio. When I found out which character I was to play and her impact in
even though 4 stars make more money
studio, and the
because getting C6 4 stars is like update. More RNG than
initially,
getting a fucking 5 star
I didn't understand but then once we recorded more
I'm joking
more, it hit me I am
it
now
hit her oh my god
family,
demon
pretty awesome it is a true honor
I wish I had holy water that I could just sprinkle
me.
On her right now for that sentence
I still can't believe I've been
Cloud
in the game for
okay,
nearly
fair.
4 years.
Also,
it's
5-star.
Wild to think that I started as Cloud Regina.
No, people only roll 5-stars though. How many people have C6 5-stars on? I do.
Not only is she a character that has helped me stretch my own vocal range, but she's also so full of life and mystery and so unintentionally hilarious. I started playing her as
I wouldn't call her hilarious, but sure.
And not so kind adept.
Also, I pulled for
and every time I
or in
for
2 or 3 Wandra banners just to get C6 Fowl Design. I'm just saying. And then I got her from Stand Up Banner, of course. Gosoyo.
Or some deeply sad backstories. So when I was asked to give her life as the playable Shen Yun, one was over the moon. I mean, with her human form, I would be able to share her softer side, the side that we've only had glimpses of.
And they fucked up the design horrendously, except on the face. The face, like, top tier, and then the rest, like, what the fuck happened there, man?
Sassy and loving character that she is. I mean, she is the type of character.
And
that
next year we get
Madame
Ping, right?
So many people throughout the year.
Mommy Ping.
So. Thank you so much for asking me to be her.
I don't like her lipstick, actually. I think it's a nice accent. I can see why you don't like it, I'm honest with you. But it somewhat fits,
man,
I would say.
I'm a nerd for this game. I love Genshin Impact.
She's a good design
journalist.
So many people. Her face, yes. Her face is pretty amazing, I would say. But the rest of the body is like...
I'm not gonna lie, it made me tear up a little.
Nah,
I know that folks are gonna be like...
I still remember Jang Yoon and Chen acting in front of Gaming Solid. That one was hilarious.
Let the man cry. Like,
yeah,
let him feel.
Like, Chen just straight up honest. Do you want me to get some flowers to eat?
We have this
Let's walk up this mountain together.
Story, really. And all we're hearing from actors is that
how about
how
we do
evolved,
some
right?
weight
like
training?
It, no one
yeah,
knows
okay, Shen,
take.
We get
just
it.
Release
okay.
this thing into the world, and then the collaborative efforts of all these people kind of morph and change, and it's developed so organically. It's really, really cool, like a living, breathing organism, but it's just art.
Yeah. And I'm just so honored that I get to be a part of this, of the English cast, with you and everybody
Dude,
else.
The shit goes on for yeah. 2 hours, though.
Well, everyone, that's a wrap on Tevat.
I knew it. I knew it. They would do it exactly
in.
That long.
Yeah, these four
this
years
is a good summary.
Of Genshin Impact
good shit,
have
dude.
Been amazing, and the adventure continues on.
Adventure continues on. Amazing. Is there some ending thing? Or just black screen nothing? It looks like a black screen and nothing. I can't believe it, man. It's finally Jova. Unbelievable, man. This took a fucking forever. Let me click the link, get a virus quickly. Okay, the preview. Let's check. What do we have? Okay, we have, first up, 3 characters. Mulani, absolutely adorable. I like her a lot. Just like Kiching Kiching. We get a 5-star for free. Standard banner 5-star. That shit is... Yeah. Okay? That thing is... That's pretty good. After the version hits live, that's even better. So, I will get my, I guess, their consolation right on patch day. That's pretty fucking amazing. 24 hour stream goes... Starts hardcore. Mulani's on the first banner, so I get my Mulani as well, because I'm winning 50-50. We get a new gadget and a new pet. Kaboom box and firstborn fire spread. Pretty good. Sanctifying elixir one time. That's so cringe. Why is only one, man? That pisses me off. I need more. We get 20 pulls. Top up reset. I don't care about that shit. We get 3 of the craftable weapons, which is pretty good. For... I'm hitting the web page, which will be live later on, probably. Archon Quest now give more premium gemmies. Tribal Chronicles. Within designated duration to gain extra premium gemmies and extra things to level up characters to level 16. I pretty neat. Quick start, Garbo. We will have higher chances for 5 stars. How exactly it works, we don't know yet. We don't know the numbers. They will say that in-game once the shit drops live. So that's pretty good. We will get a few pulls for that shit. And okay, that's pretty neat. Anyways, it's so fucking bright here. As you can see, I'm in the middle of the fucking sun circle. I'll end my stream quickly, right? To upload this shit to YouTube. Hello, YouTube, once again. Thanks for tuning in for this long journey. Shit, 2 hours, man. If you're still here, amazing. I love you. But like, for subscribe. Drop a comment, man. It's fucking amazing. I hope you enjoyed the video at least. If not, I guess sucks for you. 2 hours wasted. Let's go, baby. Regardless, I'll do a 24-hour stream at 28th once the patch comes out. So watch out for that one. The link for the codes down below as well. Just click the thing, put in the links in there. I mean, not the links, the codes in there. Just use them. You'll be good. Regardless, hope you have a nice day, morning, evening, whatever the fuck you have. Have a good one. Take care of yourself. See you in the next video, which will be Theater and Abyss, which I will do in, let's say, 15 minutes. Anyways, have a good one. Take care of yourself.